TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Lipakshi Khurana. Here are the top stories we're tracking for you on Wednesday, the 4th of December. India-Maldives jointly launched development projects to boost ties. Pakistan's former President Musharraf says treason case against him baseless. And Japanese national among six killed in Afghan attack. Now for all the details, Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Wednesday said India and Maldives are committed to enhancing their cooperation for peace and mutual security in the Indian Ocean region as both the countries inaugurated key development projects via video conference. New Delhi gifted a fast interceptor vessel to the island nation in a bid to further strengthen deeper maritime security.
India on Wednesday jointly inaugurated key development projects with Maldives that were announced during last 1 year to further deepen bilateral ties between the two countries. India gifted a fast patrol vessel named Kamyab to the island nation, besides initiating the process to roll out RuPay card in Maldives and LED lighting project in its capital, Male. The launch of the global RuPay card through the Bank of Maldives will pave the way for higher tourist arrivals from India and eventually stronger people-to-people contacts between the two countries. The developments were conducted during a video conference between Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi and Maldivian President Ibrahim Soli. Expressing his deep appreciation to India for its support to the development aspirations and security of Maldives, President Soli conveyed his commitment to deepen cooperation and partnership with India.
As a close friend and maritime member, India is committed to continue partnering with Maldives for democracy and development. We will also enhance our cooperation for peace and mutual security in the Indian Ocean region.
Both leaders agreed to work closely together to enhance cooperation for peace, prosperity and mutual security of India and Maldives for the wider Indian Ocean region. The ties between the two countries are on an upswing after Soli became president in November last year.
The Indian Navy paid homage to its fallen sailors to mark the 48th Navy Day on Wednesday. The day commemorates the Indian Navy's daring attack on Karachi Harbour, which inflicted heavy damage on Pakistani vessels during the 1971 war.
The Indian Navy on Wednesday paid tributes to its fallen sailors who had sacrificed their lives during the 1971 Indo-Pakistan War to mark the occasion of the 48th Navy Day. Indian Navy Chief Admiral Karambir Singh, along with high-ranking officials of the Indian Armed Forces, laid a wreath and paid homage to the martyrs at the National War Memorial in capital New Delhi on the occasion. Every year, the Indian Navy celebrates 4th of December as the Navy Day to commemorate its daring attack on Karachi Harbour, which inflicted heavy damage on Pakistani vessels during the 1971 war. Meanwhile, officials of the armed forces also pay tributes at the World War I era memorial in India's coastal Chennai city on the occasion. The theme for this year's celebrations is Indian Navy, Silent, Strong and Swift.
I take this opportunity to thank the nation and all its citizens for the unstinted support that they have provided to the Army, Navy and Air Force in all their endeavors in the past 1 year.
As part of the celebrations, medical and blood donation camps, coastal cleanup activities, among other events, are also conducted on the occasion every year.
Pakistan's former president Parvez Musharraf has said that high treason case against him is baseless as he has served the country for almost a decade. Musharraf, who is living in Dubai in self-exile, was on Monday admitted to hospital following deterioration of his health.
Pakistan's former president Parvez Musharraf has said that high treason case against him is baseless and he is ready to record his statement in the case. Musharraf, however, showed mistrust in the judicial process, saying, "I have not been heard and I am being victimized." The ailing former military dictator's video statement from his hospital bed was shared on Twitter by M. Sahib Nabil, senior special assistant in his office. Musharraf expressed hope that he will get justice in the case. Former military dictator General Musharraf was on Monday admitted to a hospital in Dubai following deterioration of his health.
ये केस मेरी नज़र में बिल्कुल बेबुनियाद है क्योंकि मैं तो गद्दारी छोड़े मैंने तो इस मुल्क के लिए बहुत खिदमत सर अंजाम दिए हैं जंगे लड़ा हुआ हूँ मैं और मुल्क की खिदमत मैंने 10 साल की है तो इसलिए मैं समझता हूँ बेबुनियाद है अब यहाँ इस केस में मुझे सुनाई नहीं दे रहे सुनवाई मेरी नहीं हो रही है सिर्फ ये नहीं कि मुझे मेरी सुनवाई नहीं हो रही है मेरा जो लॉयर है सलमान सफ्तर उस तक को सुन नहीं रहे हैं तो मेरी नजर में ये बहुत ज्यादती हो रही है
द इस्लामाबाद हाई कोर्ट हैड लास्ट वीक सेट असाइड एन ऑर्डर ऑफ द स्पेशल कोर्ट दैट द फाइनल वर्डिक्ट इन मुशर्रफ्स हाई ट्रीजन केस वुड बी अनाउंस्ड ऑन नवंबर 28 हाउएवर द कोर्ट्स फुल बेंच वांटेड द स्पेशल कोर्ट टू डिसाइड द केस एक्सपीडिशियसली एज इट डायरेक्टेड द गवर्नमेंट टू नोटिफाई अ प्रोसिक्यूशन टीम बाय 5th ऑफ डिसंबर
Moving on, students of Karakoram International University in Gilgit-Baltistan recently staged a protest accusing Pakistan of systematically depriving the youth of Gilgit-Baltistan of seeking higher education. They demanded more varsities should be built in the illegally occupied region.
Students of Karakoram International University in Gilgit-Baltistan recently held a protest against Pakistan. Accusing the establishment of systematically depriving them of seeking higher education. The entire region of Gilgit-Baltistan has just one university, and to make matters even worse, the institution has no professional programs along with an inadequate number of teaching staff. The students said that despite repeated pleas and demands, the administration of the illegally occupied region, which largely operates at the commands of Islamabad, has been apathetic to the crisis.
گلگت بلتستان تعلیمی حساب سے سب سے پیچھے دیکھا جائے تو ایک ہی انٹرنیشنل یونیورسٹی ہے اس کے علاوہ یہ ہے کہ اتنی زیادہ طلبہ کی تعداد اور پڑھی لکھی یوتھ گلگت بلتستان میں ہونے کے باوجود ہمارے جو نوجوان ہے وہ پنڈی اسلام آباد میں جا کے تعلیم حاصل کرنے کے لیے در ودر کی ٹھوکریں کھا رہے ہیں ان لوگوں کو یہاں پہ انجینئرنگ یونیورسٹی اور یہ کہ میڈیکل یونیورسٹیاں قائم کرنی چاہیے
ہمارے نوجوانوں کے ساتھ پوری پاکستان میں جو کھیل کھیلا جا رہا ہے وہ کھیل یہ ہے کہ نوجوانوں کو آپ نے نوکر پیدا کرنا ہے نوجوانوں کو آپ نے بزدل پیدا کرنا ہے نوجوانوں کے دل و دماغ کے اندر سے ان کی طاقت ختم کر دی ہے
Such a state of affairs is not only limited to the education sector. Locals in the illegally occupied region blame either it is civil liberties, quality of life or voting rights. They have been granted almost nothing by the Pakistani establishment.
In news from Afghanistan, gunmen killed a Japanese doctor and five others in eastern Afghanistan on Wednesday. Tetsu Namakura, head of Peace Japan Medical Services, had recently been granted honorary Afghan citizenship for decades of humanitarian work in the country.
Gunmen killed six people, including the head of a Japanese aid agency, on Wednesday. In an attack on their vehicle in Jalalabad in eastern Afghanistan. The ambush comes a week after a grenade attack on a United Nations vehicle in capital Kabul heightened fears for those doing humanitarian work amid one of the world's longest-running conflicts. Tetsu Nakamura, head of Peace Japan Medical Services, had been involved in rebuilding Afghan irrigation and agriculture and had recently been granted honorary Afghan citizenship for decades of humanitarian work in the east of the country. No group had claimed responsibility for the attack till the last reports came in. Nangarhar has been a stronghold of the Islamic State militant group. The attack came as Afghan President Ashraf Ghani last month claimed victory over the Islamic State in the eastern province after more than 600 fighters along with their families surrendered to the government.
Sri Lanka's new president, Gotabaya Rajapaksa, met with members of the committee inquiring the Easter Sunday terror attacks that killed more than 250 people in April. He instructed to expedite their probe, identify those responsible for the attacks and bring them before the law.
Sri Lankan President Gotabaya Rajapaksa has instructed the committee inquiring the Easter Sunday terror attacks to expedite their probe, identify those responsible for the attacks and bring them before the law. Gotabaya met with members of the Presidential Commission of Inquiry earlier this week and exchanged the views, the President's media division said. He also slammed his predecessors for failing to prevent the bombings that led to disintegration of intelligence services. A string of suicide attacks struck churches and luxury hotels in Sri Lanka on Easter Sunday on April 21, killing 258 people, including Indians. The incident shattered a decade of peace in the island nation since the end of the brutal civil war with Tamil rebel group. After the attacks, the then President Maithripala Sirisena had said that India provided additional information but senior officials did not share the intelligence with him. Though authorities said local jihadist group National Tawhid Jamaat were responsible for the suicide bombings, their attacks were later claimed by the Islamic State terror group.
In news from Nepal, a joint military exercise between Indian and Nepali Army commenced at the Nepal Army Battle School in the country's Rupindehi district on Tuesday. This is the 14th edition of the joint military exercise Surya Kiran, which is conducted alternatively in India and Nepal. The aim of the exercise is to enhance interoperability at the military level in jungle warfare, anti-terrorism combat, as well as disaster response activities. As part of the exercise, important lectures, demonstrations and drills related to counter-insurgency and counter-terrorism operations will be conducted. The annual Sangai Festival of India's northeastern Manipur province drew scores of tourists this year. The week-long grand event aimed at promoting Manipur's rich culture and diverse traditions to the world.
The annual Sangai Festival, celebrated with an aim to showcase a rich culture and tradition of India's northeastern Manipur province, was held recently with much fanfare. Inaugurated by Chief Minister N. Biren Singh, the festival saw huge crowds, including foreign visitors, thronging various programs which were held at different venues across Manipur. Tribal dances by various tribes of the province were the major highlights of the grand event.
Enjoyment, the entertainment, everything, international,
every edition of Sangai Festival showcases the tourism potential of Manipur in the field of art, culture, handloom, and handicrafts. The festival started as a province-level event in 2010 and has now grown into a big platform for locals to showcase their rich cultural ethos and diverse traditions to the world.
Well, that's the way it was in South Asia this evening. Before we conclude, the top stories once again. India-Maldives jointly launched development projects to boost ties. Pakistan's former President Musharraf says a treason case against him baseless. And Japanese national among six killed in Afghan attack. Now our viewers can watch the show on SouthAsiaNewsline.com. You can also visit us on Facebook.com/SAsiaNewsline and follow us on Twitter @SAsiaNewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night. TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.